All right. Good to see y'all. I've waited my whole life for this. It's no joke. So, I've been saving myself, you know. I've had other opportunities for open mics, but I've saved myself for Wiley's on this night. So a couple months leading up to this, maybe since November, I decided to stay pure. No stand-up comedy. None. I didn't want to get joke envy, you know? Yeah. You're on board with that, huh? You getting on board? All right. So they say, you know, before your first time, you know, have a couple drinks, you know? Just calm down, loosen up a little. And I can't tell you how many drinks I've had tonight. Funny enough, that's what I tell all of my Uber riders when they get into my car for Uber. It could be 2 a.m. I don't know how many drinks I've had, honestly. Yeah, awesome. Thanks for laughing at that. I wrote that, I did. I really did. Mike was telling us to do original stuff, so. Maybe that's partly plagiarized from the whole porn bit, you know. Staying pure, you know, saving yourself, I don't know. So, it is my first time, and I hope you let me do something in honor of my first time, okay? I hope you let me do this. I just would like everyone to bow their head and close their eyes. Will you do that for me? Okay, nothing crazy. I know that you're eating and drinking out there. Just bow your head and close your eyes. I want you to search your heart. Just search your heart, okay? Raise your hand if you can give me a ride home tonight. Thanks, man. Oh, presents. Presents. Let's take a little peek here. Are there any Garys here? Gary? No Garys? I started this journey to find Gary, all right? They're a dying breed, man. When's the last time you met a baby named Gary? Who's naming their baby Gary? You know? You know what I mean? What the heck, man? So, I was hanging out at this establishment that I frequent. I frequent this establishment probably like 35, 40 hours a week. Catch my drift? Yeah. And there's this guy that, like, tells everybody what to do, I think. I don't know what he's talking about half the time. But he started calling me Pumpkin, okay? Never been hit on by a gay dude. I don't, you know, it's cool. But, you know, I was, like, thinking, like, about the Me Too movement and all, and I was like, you know, maybe I just feel a little uncomfortable that he's kind of just hitting on me, calling me Pumpkin, so... One day, I show up to this establishment and punch my numbers in, you know? And I'm like, I'm gonna say something. So I'm gonna tell him, you know, I'm a little uncomfortable being called Pumpkin. And he's coming my way, I'm like, getting up the nerve. I'm like, all right, it's going down. He's like, Pumpkin? I'm like, he said, you're getting a raise. I said, Pumpkin Mike. So I'm gay now. 35 to 40 hours a week. Thanks. Hey, thanks. You know. Let's talk after the show. Well, let me send you off with this, all right? Because, you know, we're in the new year. In a couple of months, March will roll around. I just want to encourage you to invest in stocks that where the company makes vasectomy. Whatever they use for vasectomies, all right? Yeah. Because statistics show that when March rolls around, that's when men do vasectomies. They want to take 2 weeks off work and watch March Madness. And that is nuts. Or is it? I don't know. It was nuts. Thanks, Zach. Not anymore. We can both use that one if you want. Okay, we can both use that. Well, thanks for having me. This has been a dream come true. Love you, Wiley. I'm not a virgin anymore. I just lost my comedy virginity. Give it up for our next comedian. His name is Kyle Kemper coming to the stage. All right, let me hear it, everyone.